United States has delivered several of its Patriot missiles to Israel to help defend itself against future missile attacks by Iraq. American forces have taken their first prisoners of war, 12 Iraqis captured in the North Arabian Sea. And Jordan's King Hussein is pleading with Iraq and the Allied forces to stop the shooting. More news later.
And get Persian Gulf updates from CNN on WMAQ Radio.
Things are getting serious at the home of the cat.
A new $32,000 91 Town Car, your total cost $22,984. A new $20,500 91 Grand Marquis, $15,950, your total cost. A new $17,700 91 Sable, $11,993, your total cost. All taxes and title charges included.
Only the best price sells cars, so we've got the competition on the run. Number one in the nation, Libertyville Lincoln Mercury. The home of the cat on Milwaukee Avenue in Libertyville.
Stephanie Powers is marked for murder Sunday.
This is the NBC Television Network.
We all have doubts that we have to do, things that we have to go about, but if the situation overseas doesn't weigh on your mind first, then it's something wrong. You're not really American because you have to be concerned about our troops.
This is the NBC Sports Prudential Update. Now, Gail Gardner.
And welcome to our Prudential Update studio in New York. Weekends are traditionally a time set aside for the enjoyment of sports and sporting events in this country, whether as a spectator or a participant. But there are times when the escapism and pure pleasure of such endeavors seems very much at odds with the realities of the world and our lives. Such is certainly the case right now. It is hopefully with great sensitivity and awareness that we proceed with our sports programming today at NBC. We will first be going to Chicago for the 42nd annual NHL All-Star Game, and later some of the top college football players in the country will showcase their talents in the Kodak Hula Bowl from Honolulu. We will, of course, work with NBC News to bring you updates throughout the day, and we will immediately join NBC News should events warrant. Ever since the war in the Gulf started 3 days ago, one of the questions being asked in the world of sports has been, should we be playing the games at all?
Whatever the league decides to do, you know, it's our job to go play. We have to try to put that out of our mind.
I'm sure people over there don't want us to come to a halt and just stop everything. I'm sure they'd want us to continue to.
I guess you have to look at it this way. They have to take care of what's over there in the Middle East, and we have to take care of what's out here on this field Sunday.
It's a major event taking place in history, but it's also when you get out there, you know, your mind goes back to what you have to do.
I think if you poll everybody in this room, they realize it's a game, and just like there's a war over there, but how many people are at work today? I think the great majority of people went to work today. This is where I work, and so I go to work today. It's where you work, so you have to go to work. And so life goes on, but you still are concerned.
It's got to be difficult being in a foxhole shooting bullets and stuff, but for them to see home and see that it's still going on, great. It'd be a good release for them.
I think it's hard to focus on this. It really makes the significance of this basketball game very, very small.
It's hard to really play and relax and enjoy yourself and have fun while someone's over there defending your honor, and it's tough.
I think about it all the time. It's the first thing on my mind. I go to sleep thinking about it. I wake up thinking about it. At this point, all we can do is pray for the guys that's over there, and hopefully everybody come back home safe.
We should point out that Richard Coffey fulfilled a six-year military commitment, which ended in 1986 with the 82nd Airborne. Well, as the NHL All-Stars take the ice, they too will be thinking of events in the Persian Gulf. And a few minutes ago, we got this response from two of them.
Everybody in America has their eyes glued to the TV, and whenever we're not playing the game or whatever, I think we're glued to the TV just like anybody else. But I think if anything, 3 hours of a great hockey game here this afternoon, I think will just do people good.
Well, my first emotions were not to play, that we should stay home and show support to our troops overseas and the other countries that are supporting us. And now I realize kind of that it is a job for us, and this is just like anybody else going to work. And we're also showing some people some entertainment for a few hours to maybe take their mind off this.
And tomorrow on NBC, the AFC Championship game will be played in Buffalo, pitting the Raiders against the Bills. Now, last week, the Raiders advanced by beating the Bengals 20-10, but Bo Jackson was hurt on this play. He sustained both a hip and knee injury and is listed on the official Raider report as doubtful for tomorrow. The Raiders will be practicing at Rich Stadium in about 10 minutes, but right now, let's check in live with O.J. Simpson. O.J., what's the latest word you have on Bo Jackson?
Well, Gail, I saw Bo when he got off the bus last night when he arrived here in Buffalo, and he was limping noticeably. The word out of the Raider camp is that he's definitely not going to play tomorrow, and I suspect that his injury is a little more severe than a simple hip pointer. As a matter of fact, the indications that I've been getting from players and some of the people in management is that even if they were to beat the Bills tomorrow, that it appears as if more than likely Bo would not play in a Super Bowl. So it's not good news for the Raiders, Gail.
All right, O.J. Simpson from Buffalo. We will be checking in with O.J. later, coming up between periods of the National Hockey League All-Star Game. We'll have more on tomorrow's game. And we will have the latest on the situation in the Persian Gulf from NBC News. Until then, enjoy the hockey game.
Chicago Stadium in Chicago, Illinois, NBC Sports proudly presents the 42nd annual NHL All-Star Game.
A capacity crowd, better than 17,000 at Chicago Stadium, home of the Chicago Blackhawks, the team with the best overall record in the NHL. They've come out for the 42nd National Hockey League All-Star Game, and we are delighted to bring it to you. Hi, everybody. I'm Marv Albert, along with John Davidson, the one-time goaltender for the New York Rangers and the St. Louis Blues, now the television color commentator for the Rangers. And, John, a year ago in Pittsburgh, it was a wild 12-7 all-star affair. Talking with Wales conference coach Mike Bilbury, he vowed, he said that will not happen again, will not be the same scene, will not be wide-open hockey. Do you buy that?
Well, one thing that is accurate is the fact that the ice surface here in Chicago, Marv, is 15 feet shorter than the average ice surface around the National Hockey League. And Mike Milbury said because of that, we may even see some body contact in this one.
Now, unfortunately, 46-goal scorer Brett Hull of the St. Louis Blues is sidelined, will not be in action because of a sprained ankle. However, added to the roster, two of the most dynamic players over the last decade in the NHL, Guy Lafleur of Quebec and Dennis Savard of Montreal, one-time Chicago Blackhawk, and they should get the crowd going.
And along with those two, add Wayne Gretzky, who's playing in his 11th National Hockey League All-Star Game. And the noted playmaker is becoming a goal scorer. When you talk about All-Star Games, Marv, has 10 goals in his previous 10 games.
And to make Gretzky even more effective, if that's possible, he will be skating with his Los Angeles King linemates, Tomas Sandstrom and Luke Robitaille. Now, we are joined on today's telecast by a man who was on two Stanley Cup championship teams over his 11-year NHL career. He is now the television color commentating voice of the Philadelphia Flyers, Bill Clement. Let's go downstairs to Bill.
Okay, Marv, thanks very much. Right now I'm on the players' bench. No doubt I'll get squeezed out of here when the guys arrive, but that won't be all bad. It'll give me a chance to stroll through the respective teams' locker rooms between periods and show everybody what these guys really do during intermission. Also want to try and bring some of the great history of Chicago Stadium to the people at home, and there is a ton of it here. So many unique features. If I hit unique feature number 37, Marv, I'll count on you to tell me whether I've gone too far.
All right, Bill, we will definitely inform you. We are now set for the introduction of the starting lineups. Let's go to the play-by-play voice of the Chicago Blackhawks on the public address. Here is Pat Foley.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome in our television hookup with NBC and hockey fans around the world, including those on the Armed Forces Network, to the most exciting hockey arena in the world, Chicago Stadium. Here are the coaches and the starters for today's 42nd annual NHL All-Star Game. First, let's meet the coach of the Prince of Wales Conference. He led his team, the Boston Bruins, to the Stanley Cup Finals in his first season behind the bench. Here is Mike Milbury. Prince of Wales Conference as selected in Dodge and Chrysler Canada All-Star Fan Balloting. In goal, from the Montreal Canadiens, the Vezina Trophy winner as top NHL goaltender in each of the last two seasons, number 33, Patrick Waugh. Bruins leading his team in both goals and plus minus, number 8, Cam Neely. At wing from the Philadelphia Flyers leading his team in both goals and points, number 22, Rick Tocchet. Quebec Nordiques leading his team in all major offensive categories, number 19, Joe Sakic. On defense from the Pittsburgh Penguins, he recently became the second defenseman in NHL history to score 1,000 points, number 7, Paul Coffey. The Wales Conference captain. He's been a postseason All-Star in each of his 11 NHL seasons. Number 77, Ray Bourque. Now the coach of the Clarence Campbell Conference.
For the native of Chicago, a member of the Blackhawks, and an all-star first-teamer, Chris Chelios. We'll be back in a moment.
Good food is a way of life. We make it every day.
serve it up at McDonald's, but we have help along the way. So thanks to the man, thanks to the woman who painted the plow and worked the land, the butcher, the baker, and the long haul maker. Thanks to the woman, thanks to the man. Permit me to include everyone who helps us make the food.
So thanks to the man, thanks to the woman who take the plow and work the land, the butcher, the baker, and the long haul maker.
Thanks to the woman.
What do you call a car that out-accelerates a Ferrari Testarossa or a Lotus Esprit? Out-corners a Porsche Carrera. Has been called the affordable Ferrari by Motor Trend. And was named one of the world's top 10 performance car values. You call it the Dodge Stealth RT Turbo. Now choose from four Stealth models starting at $16,552. Welcome home, America. Advantage, Dodge.
For 25 years, you've watched exciting Super Bowl games at rather unexciting Super Bowl parties. This year, all that could change. To celebrate 25 years of breathtaking action, Scope's throwing a big Super Bowl 25 party right in your area. To enter, look for details at participating stores. It's your chance to rub elbows with famous sports stars and even win a trip to the 1992 Pro Bowl in Hawaii. The Super Bowl 25 party from Scope. It'll be so exciting, everyone will want to crash.
Raiders, the Bills,
ow!
The AFC Championship game, Sunday.
This, one of the great arenas in sports, Chicago Stadium, and that holds true for both the Blackhawks of the NHL and the Chicago Bulls of the NBA. Let's return to the public address.
Ladies and gentlemen, during this afternoon's NHL All-Star Game, a United Nations flag decal will be worn on the helmet of each All-Star. The NHL and the NHL Players Association join millions of people around the world in expressing support for the servicemen and women of many nations in the Persian Gulf, seeking to enforce the decision of the Security Council of the United Nations. At this time, we request that you stand for a moment of silence to express, in your own way, our hopes and prayers for our courageous servicemen and women.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now, to sing the national anthems, please welcome Wayne Messmer, accompanied by organist Frank Pellico.
Oh,
Rendition, emotional reaction, strong support for our armed forces in the Persian Gulf who are seeing this telecast live. Our thoughts, our prayers are with you.
So you're going to finally meet Cindy, huh?
Tonight. Good. So first impressions are very important.
I think.
Okay. Now, imagine. Lights are low, the music's soft. Knock the door. The door opens up. Somebody's out there doing this.
What is this? She's got dandruff?
No, you have dandruff.
No.
Yes, you do.
I shampoo every day.
You can shampoo your brains out with regular shampoo.
Shampoo
wouldn't matter.
Your brains out?
Yeah, well, so use that.
Head and Shoulders?
Works for me, my friend.
But you don't have dandruff.
Exactamundo!
Head and Shoulders. Because you never get a second chance to make a first impression.